This program is brought to you by the Government Communication and Information System. Good evening, South Africa. My name is Busisiwe Gumede Chijanje, your guide on Citizens Connect. Tonight, we reflect on the incredible journey of farmers in our country. Join me as we unravel stories of those who take part in a sector that is crucial to our economic growth and food security.
My name is Dr. Ntabise Matla. I am a founder of Icon Agri Pro, which is a small enterprise, farming enterprise, which is in the Vaal. So currently I'm farming with chickens. So we have a laying compartment, and we also have a hatchery.
Ikamalam ndingum Maxwell Mzonzima Matinda. Lapha kule farm sikwi Sedcom farm thina sisebenza apha ke mna ndihlala apha as umuntu oyi caretaker ojongene le ndawo. At the same time we run this farm, this project as a cooperative ukuthi siproduce sikhiphe ukudla sikwazi ukubeka iplate etafuleni.
So I'm also a medical doctor by profession. So initially, farming was my husband's passion, is my husband's passion. So it is an opportunity, an additional income stream. There's always need for dijo, but we hloka hoja all the time. So I thought, you know, why not? Let's do this. And that's basically why. So initially it was because in a lot of passion and that, but I saw it as an income stream, so as a way of making income.
So kale ngo 2015, besibayi 14, but ngenxa yento yokuba abantu bajonge into yoba mabafumane imali kunoba baqale basebenze bona, so abanye bayeka, abanye baphuma. So injongo yethu thina kuthi njengoba sistarta this project senza i-mixed farming. In fact iyabona siyafuya, siyalima, sifuya inkuku, sifuya inkomo, sifuya ibhokhwe. So injongo yethu want to ekuhambeni kwexesha siproduce simanufacture ukuthi ukutya everything, into yoba luba siqale futhi ekulimeni sikwazi ukuproducer, sikwazi ukwenza i-products esizakwazi uphinde sifide i-animals esinaso kule ndawo.
Yeah, my emerging farmers have got a lot of challenges that we see. Access to capital, access to technology, access to technical skills. So it's important that we address with our small scale farmers. From the data that is available, they are only contributing 10% of the food production in the country. So we want to increase the food production space within the small scale, who's a greater market of the share into the formal markets.
The challenges of this business, number one, I'm on PESAL. So I do locums for the government. So I give money funding from the government because I'm on PESAL. So it means from my pocket and from the household pocket. So this plot that we are at, that is the one thing. Number two, so it means what we should ideally be making profit so that we can pay the bond. So at this point, re patala bond ka chelete rona ya di salary tsa rona.
Agriculture is a very difficult sector to be in. It's not easy, but once you get to do to be in agriculture, then you see the benefits over the long term. It's not a short-term business. As you can see, Ifarm Lay started in 2016 and it's 26 hectares. It will take another 5-10 years to fully develop this whole farm, but it needs patience and effort and focus.
When you look at other businesses, if I was not on PESAL, let's say I was just running my private practice, I would actually qualify for a grant from the government, which does not really make sense, because I could be making the same amount of money that I get from the government from my company in private, but then I benefit, you know, for a grant. I qualify for a grant, which I feel like it's unfair. I feel like it's unfair because other businesses which are good, are big and are doing very well, they still benefit because they're not connected to the government in terms of employment.
It's very important in that we collaborate with the government. The government is doing its own part and we're also doing our own part. And so working together creates the opportunity to, you know, to escalate the programs that we are all running together. We just need better coordination so that we can spread the resources or utilize the resources better than we are doing at the moment.
It's equipment, especially equipment yokulima fast, because lo mhlaba nje ubona apha sina 26 hectares esingayilima, we can product. Si produce a crop, si produce a vegetables, si produce even a fruits singakwazi ukuya lapho, but ngenxa into ba asinamandla, yabona asinamandla amaninji, so we are not able to do that now.
If we've got land, rena le mobu re ka producer dijo, why should we be having imports tsa dijo tse basic, you know, when we've got land e dutse mona e ya itsha fela, you know, we've got land in South Africa, so we can actually, anyone ananle land ananle a business, not just the plan but everything is sebetsang. I feel like they can bring a solution ya dijo in South Africa. So I believe, Hore, as a business person, you are more of a solution bearer. And Dabaya, how it's honestly in quite serious, Hore, how can we then help you and protect this vision that you have so that it can benefit the country?
We've just scratched the surface on the incredible stories unfolding in the heart of South Africa's farms. The challenges faced by our farmers are not just individual struggles. They resonate across the fields, impacting the very backbone of our nation. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back after this break. Welcome back. You're still watching Citizens Connect. Agriculture is the backbone of our economy, and over the years we've seen an increasing number of young people, more especially black farmers, infiltrating the market, which is of course a good thing. But many of them are complaining about a lack of access to funding, and those are issues that agencies or funding agencies like the NYDA, the National Youth Development Agency, is positioned to deal with. Perhaps we should begin with you, Lwazi, and get an understanding of the agency. Why was it formed and what exactly is its mandate?
So the NYDA was formed in the year 2008, and it carries the mandate of empowering young people and mainstreaming the interests of young people across all sectors of society, not just government, but public private sector as well, and ensuring that young people have got a common voice and they are not excluded from all economic activities of the country. So the programs that we have since started to offer moved from just being a funding agency where it serviced a lot of young entrepreneurs to enable them to penetrate the market and basically break the barriers that were initially created, but we've since evolved to also understanding the work that is being done in civil society, and we work very closely with civil society through our NPO capacity building programs as well as our National Youth Service Program. I think the common perception around the agency is that we just offer grants and funding, but we have become a bit more holistic in terms of the offerings of the agency since its inception.
A business like Olseselisha, and you're still learning along the way, ukuthi mhlambe lokhu kumele ngiyenze, this I cannot do. Yini ama challenges that you're dealing with at the moment?
Okay, so initially the challenge is I have an entrepreneurial mind, right? Empa hage motho wa business. I guess I I don't have a degree, you know. So I had to, I'm currently enrolled in a program, yeah, United Nations Development Program, Mokintsenge, it's a course, yeah, entrepreneurship and financial literacy, because kibona hore, it's one thing to have a skill, but it's another to develop a skill of business management. Mm. So now I'm at a stage where I'm like, I'm mastering the small enterprise. So going commercial, then funding, because at the moment I'm still running on our household income funds. Mm. Yes. Mm. So, and I'm at a place where I'm not really making profit, you know, the economy of scales as well. So I get a profit, funding. I am doing sessions for the government as a medical doctor. So government ya mpatala for doing sessions at a hospital, and therefore I don't qualify for funding like NYDA.
Ke ntone ke batlo itsho gore mathata that you are talking about, you know, now we are vuma magaloga khuluma ukuthi okay, no, check, these are the issues that you can help her address.
So from the conversations that we're having, I think it's quite crucial to highlight that government employees, there are means and ways for them to apply for various forms of support from the state. However, it is also quite crucial for them to equally declare and that they know what team. There's no conflict of interest, particularly for it to be perceived as them doing business with the state, because they are then obtaining a different form of income from the state. So it is quite crucial that those that seek to source funding or source various resources from government try and exercise it within the parameters of the law, so that they do not find themselves compromising their employment status and also compromising their interest in terms of their core obligations to government. So I think it's quite important for people to just do the necessary research on how it is that they can then declare their interests should they seek to source funding from Hulumeni.
Shouldn't then we be looking at changing the current, you know, requirements or funding models that are pushed by the NYDA? I mean, surely a person like Dr. Madla should be, you know, considered for something like funding, because she's number one solving a problem.
Yeah.
But we can't necessarily have her leave her profession because we still need medical doctors in our country, you know. So shouldn't the agency be looking at ways of assisting people like Dr. Madla?
Absolutely. But I think that funding from the state is quite limited and lean. Our funding threshold currently is sitting at 250,000 rand. And I think that, yes, that might be impactful, but I think in the magnitude of work that she would like to see her business translate to, it might sometimes, for a lot of other entrepreneurs, become a drop in the ocean. So what we then do is create that link between yourself and someone who then can take you from good to great, where it is that we feel as though we have limitations and shortfalls in a particular sector.
There's a lot of people who are just like me. Government has got how many employees, you know, who, because of the policies that are in place, are bound to the little that they have. They have great ideas. They want to change the well-being of their families. They want to change the well-being of their communities, but they're quite restricted.
And I can see Dr. Madla is just dying to jump in. I'll give you a chance when we return. You're still watching Citizens Connect. How do you, as a government employee or as an individual who is on the government's payroll, get access to government-led agencies or government-supported agencies like the NYDA? We'll discuss solutions when we come back. Welcome back to Citizens Connect. Today we're talking about funding opportunities for young people, specifically those in the agriculture market. And I'm sure you're wondering who's this man that's next to me. His name is Qedusizi Nyoka, and he's the Acting Director of Subsistence Farming in the Ministry of Agriculture, Land Reform and Rural Development. Baba, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.
Ngicela ukuthi kahle kahle yini i-subsistence farming? Ihluke kanjani from the farming that, for example, Dr. Matla is doing?
Okay, subsistence farming is what we can refer as backyard farming or household producer. So it is at a much lower scale than what Dr. Matla is doing right now. But it's a level that is gearing up for that that level, yeah, Dr. Matla.
Siyafisa ukuthi abantu abasendaweni zasemakhaya, ema peri-urban areas, ema lokishini, ikakhulukazi youth, ake bathathe isibonelo. Bazi-identify lezi ndawo lezi ezingasebenzi, ezihleli nje ezingenalutho. Baqale bona ngokwabo, ye bayiqalele ngokwabo, ikakhulukazi laba abane-passion ye-agriculture. Bathi bephakamisa isandla, bathi bacela usizo, kube kukhona esikubonayo asebeqalile bakwenza. Kuba lula kakhulu-ke lapho ukuthi sisondele eduzane njenge-government ukuthi hayi nangumuntu osebenzayo kuphi lapho esingamsiza khona.
So nina yini umsebenzi eniwuyenzayo? Is it to just empower these backyard farmers to get to that level or to help them at the level at which they are in?
That's correct, both. But we start by looking at policies that will help them to graduate from that level of subsistence farming to smallholder farming. But at the same time, we want to make sure that they get all the support that they need at that level, because that's the basic of all the farming activities. And the main objective of subsistence farming is food security, household food security. So they can produce at their own level, and if there is excess, they can start selling. That's when they start graduating to the next level.
Umthetho wakhona nje vele ipolicy idevelopheka ngenxa yama conversations asuka kubantu on the ground. So le conversation ekade iqhubeka njengamanje iveze izinto ezidinga ukuthi zike zibuyekezwe kuma policies esinawo. So ama discussions anjengalawa nama forums anjengalawa esiwadingayo ukuthi kancane kancane sihlale sibone sibuke ukuthi sisahamba ngakho yini njengohulumeni, uhulumeni omkhulu nohulumeni basemazingeni e-province naphansi. Sibuke futhi ukuthi lokho esikwenzayo kuseyizinto ezidinga umphakathi yini, noma sizenzela nje okwethu, siyanhlanhlatha nje.
Babunyonga, awusitshele ngabantu odila nabo, oxhumane nabo kule project yenu in the ministry. Umama, of course, is a medical doctor. Kodwa uyayithanda into yakhe ye-farming and ufuna ukucommercialize as well. I wonder if you deal with the same kind of people in subsistence farming as well, who push their projects but also have a 9-to-5 job. And has that prevented them from getting access to funding?
You know, as she's explaining her role in the community, I'm not thinking about agriculture only as the department and funding as such, as money going into her account. But there are other government programs, or like we have the district development model in government. Ethatha ama levels wonke government, from local municipality, district, even national, including a business in around the area and communities, in which projects like this maybe can leverage, because that's where they come together, pull in the resources, but kubonakala ukuthi kuphi lapha angasizakala khona.
Abana inkinga mhlambe ukuthi she's on government's payroll, or that she has a 9-to-5 at a public hospital.
Like I'm trying to explain, I'm not looking at funding as money going into her account, but looking at the project as a whole. Ukuthi ingasizakala kanjani kule model ye district development model. I Department of Agriculture, more especially national, iya participate kakhulu lapho. Kule district development model.
Initially, I had thought that it's a complete barrier, me being employed by the government as a complete barrier for me from getting any kind of assistance. And besides the issue of funding, then I also got the fact that they are actually able to assist in other ways, which for me, the highlight was the market. I believe I know now who to approach.
Looking at her case, it would require of us to dissect how it is that you are able to source the necessary support, but you do declare the interests that you have in the different industries that you are a role player in.
How nahana, Dr. Matla, do you think that could at least boost business yahao and UFO tool so that you desperately need?
Absolutely.
Siyabadinga abantu abanjengayo. Siyabadinga kakhulu abantu abanjengayo ngoba one baqala from ama resources aba sephaketheni. Bakhande umsebenzi. Izwe elinjenge South Africa eli free market, ama entrepreneurs akhanda umsebenzi, ama small business akhanda imsebenzi. Uma ngakhuthazwa abantu abanjengayo sibe nabo babe baningi. Inkinga yokushodakala kwemisebenzi singazama ukuyinqoba. Ama local offices wethu ana section esibiza nge extension and advisory service. Ilapho okunikezwa khona ama technical skills kubantu asebevele sebeqalile. Kanti ke nama ama programs ethu njenge esibiza nge ilima litsima iyavuleleka ukuthi abantu ba apply ema local officeini bathole usizo lwento zokusebenza bakwazi ukuqala ukusebenza. Iphesi ke yona iyenze imanga ngoba ivundulule abantu abanye bebengaziwa na ma local offices ukuthi baya produce nabakade befihlala befisa ukuproducer kodwa bengakwazi ukuthi bazoqala kanjani bazoqala ngani. Uma kuvela ama opportunities avezwa iphesi saqala sabona ama farmers amasha nanamhlanje abanye babo baya produce futhi bayimisela ngokuqhubeka.
I think I came here with quite a frustration. I tried to balance my mind and my thoughts, so I pulled it all together. But I'm quite excited about the information that I got today. And from the subsistence farming side, I'm so excited because I feel like it's an answer to a prayer.
Thank you to Citizens Connect for creating such a platform where it is that information can be shared and we divorce ourselves from not having the necessary knowledge about not just government, but other offerings.
Oh, that brings us to the end of our conversation. Sibonga kakhulu sisom. Thank you so much to my guests. And of course, kuningi esikufundile about farming and funding. Thank you so much for staying with us here and joining us, of course, here on Citizens Connect.